and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Sometimes I feel like I'm in the dark when it comes to what you would call nano or microflow chromatography. It sounds really cool, but also really hard. So in this episode of Behind the Science, I think it's time to be enlightened by this technique. Jim, you're just the person I was looking for.
Oh, Jen, I've been expecting you.
I guess my reputation precedes me.
You got it.
So, actually, the question that I have that I think you can help me out with is that I've been learning a lot about analytical chromatography. However, I've heard these terms of nano and microflow, and I think you might know something about that.
I probably am. So microflow is really when we lower the flow rate below analytical scale. It could be anywhere from 100 microliters a minute down to 1 microliter a minute.
Interesting. Do you have any more specific examples?
Yeah, let me explain it to you. We only really use microflow when we need ultimate sensitivity. Let me explain why. So let me explain why we see such a big sensitivity gain at microflow. It all really has to do with electrospray. At high flow rates, when you're operating, say, at 600 microliters a minute, you really have to pump in a lot of heat and gas to get these fine droplets. And you end up with this really broad and diverse plume. And the mass spectrometer only samples just a very small fraction of it. But if we decrease the flow rate, we can get a very fine plume, a very small plume. And the mass spectrometer can get more of that. I make the analogy of like my daughter, all right? You can imagine my daughter drinking from a water fountain. She could probably do a pretty good job drinking from a water fountain at school. She might get a little bit on her dress, but she does a good job. But just imagine now if you take her out back in front of a hose. Same girl, just not as efficient.
Wow, that analogy was great, but your poor daughter.
Ah, she loved it.
Well, that's a good thing. So the sensitivity gains sound great. However, I've heard that this technique is really hard. Is it worth it?
Who have you been talking to? The sensitivity gains have potential of being huge depending on analyte, and it's actually quite easy to use. Let me explain why. The plot you see here shows the sensitivity enhancement for a series of small molecules in relation to a 2.1 millimeter separation performed on an acuity. The same volume and concentration of the sample were injected on each column format. As we reduce the column dimension from a 2.1 millimeter, the 150 micron dimension appears to be an inflection point where the observed sensitivity gain begins to increase non-linearly with the flow rate. For this series of molecules, a 4 to 30x gain can be observed, and for peptides, it's a whole lot more.
All right, Jim, you've sold me on the sensitivity. However, I'm still a little apprehensive on the complexity of this technique. What if I can't find you and have questions?
That's a good question. Waters has two great resources. We have our application notebook that has a lot of information about applications ranging from pharma to food safety. And Patty, our product manager, just started a really informational blog on our Waters website.
I'm right here.
Oh, you're everywhere.
When I started this episode, I had no idea what nano or microflow chromatography was, except that it sounded cool, but also hard. I have a new appreciation for this technique, and I don't think I'll be getting the analogy of the water hose and that poor little girl out of my head anytime soon. The sensitivity gains can be astounding, and if you're sample limited, this could be exactly what you need. Check out the link below to learn more about microflow, and make sure you follow our blog to keep up to date with new advances, so you're not left in the dark like I was. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science.